Evo India does this amazing series called Gone But Not Forgotten, and every time I drive my Rids, I kind of feel the same. I clearly remember shortlisting the Rids and picking it up over the Swift as an practical option, where my dad appreciated the space and cut the check for the down payment, while my mom chose the Baker chocolate color for the ugly duckling. I remember somewhere in 2022, we did a couple of test drives with my dad for the Rids replacement, and we were kind of disappointed to find out how difficult was it to get a replacement for the Rids in the sub 10-12 lakh segment. The 1.2K series engine is punchy and efficient at the same time, while the gearbox aids the performance with a light clutch. Our ZXI variant gets dual airbag and ABS, the 185 section 14-inch tires suit well to the car where the suspension is set up for comfort. And most of this car is about that, with height adjustable seat, steering, adjustable seat belt mount, powered mirrors. Most of these features are still reserved for the premium variant of cars these days, like the rear washer and wiper. Of course, cars didn't get those TV size screens back then, but the 4 speaker system was decent and it also got the steering mounted controls. What stands out in the Rids is the dash-mounted RPM meter. It looks so cool, especially when it lights up in the night. Almost everyone who sits in the car asks about it. The Rids is so much about space and usability. The doors open wide, the cabin has got a lot of storage, 60-40 split seats in the rear, and it is spacious with big windows that makes the cabin feel roomy. I personally love the high driving position offered by the Rids. The air conditioning chills the cabin pretty well, and in terms of reliability, it is something that I can really count on. This has been an absolute low maintenance car. In the last 5 years, I don't remember spending anything big other than periodic oil, filter and fluid changes, maybe a wheel bearing and battery in the expected consumables. Unlike most Marutis of that generation, the Rids actually feels and drives strong with close to 1100 kilos of curb weight. Of course, that does not acclaim for any additional safety, but it doesn't rattle like others. I remember shortlisting some replacement cars, but I guess that's the topic for a different video. Let me know in the comments if you have got some experience to share with the Rids or with some other practical cars from the last decade like the Figo, Jazz and others. Before I end this video, let me show you the spare wheel that came in as a full-size alloy wheel, which is something you cannot see in today's time. So that's it for this video, and I hope you guys have liked it.